So I already made a video yesterday with my top 10 favorite iOS 14 features, like for example, the new compact Siri and incoming call notification, which no longer takes up the entire screen. But for this video, I'm gonna address things that Apple didn't mention at the WWDC event, and some of these things are awesome. By far, the one I'm most excited for is keyboard and mouse gaming support coming to the iPad soon. And this is straight from Apple's developer training website. So soon, we'll be able to hook up a mouse and play Fortnite using Apple's Magic Keyboard case for the iPad Pro. Next up, Apple is opening up third-party controller support APIs to developers. So while some Xbox controllers are already gaining support, we could see PlayStation controllers gain support very soon. Another huge feature Apple didn't mention was that iOS and iPadOS 14 will now support YouTube's VP9 codec. So we can finally get 4K YouTube video support, which people have been asking for years now. Now before hidden feature number 4, I want to mention that our new premium Apple product t-shirts are available in our merch shelf just below this video. So thank you guys for supporting us. For feature number 4, Apple has added a sound recognition feature that will notify you when your iPhone detects sounds like a crying baby or a fire alarm, greatly helping deaf people. One of the most impressive features is the ability to double tap or triple tap the back of your iPhone to do things like open apps, the control center, the app switcher, and more, like double tapping the back to bring down the notification center, which is a pain to do on a lot of the larger iPhones. One Twitter user even opened up Google Assistant using the new back tap feature. Hidden feature number 6 is that you'll finally get a notification when your AirPods are low on battery, instead of just a chime in one of your ears. iOS 14 will now also give you a notification when your Apple Watch is fully charged, which will be perfect if you're using the new sleep tracking feature and need to charge in the morning before work. Feature number 8 is the headphone accommodations option, which lets you customize and tune the audio on Apple and Beats headphones, and you can find it in the audio and visual settings within the accessibility settings. There's also a new option to reduce loud headphone sounds, which lets you know what type of sounds typically create volume that loud. Another cool feature is the ability to use a private Wi-Fi address, which prevents network operators from tracking your iPad. And just below that option, there's a new low data mode, which reduces your data usage by pausing automatic updates and things like that. On to hidden feature number 12, the iPad now has a new option in the pointer control settings for the Magic Keyboard and other hardware keyboards that enables you to turn on and customize double tap to drag, which was previously tough to use with iPadOS 13. Another cool feature is that you can now ask Siri to send an audio message to someone so you don't have to rely on Siri's voice to text, which sometimes doesn't work that well, and this would be great for sending a message in another language. And a huge bonus is that it works with CarPlay as well. There are also new Siri options in the accessibility settings, which allow you to set Siri so that she doesn't speak when your device is in silent mode, or other options that you prefer. Something else I spotted on Apple's developer website is that Face ID and Touch ID login is coming to Safari, bypassing the need to use the current Safari password autofill feature. Alongside sleep tracking coming to the Apple Watch, we now get a new sleep mode, which replaces bedtime mode from iOS 13, which will help you meet your sleep goal. And it works with the new wind down mode, which helps reduce distractions as you get ready for bed. On to feature number 17, there's finally a new mirror front camera feature for both iPhone and iPad, so your selfies will look exactly like when you took them instead of mirroring them horizontally. On top of that, the performance of taking photos has been greatly improved, like taking photos up to 90% faster, and portrait photos up to 15% faster than before. Number 19 is updated night mode photos, which can now take advantage of the gyroscope to help you keep your iPhone still, and you now finally have the option to cancel a night mode photo in mid-capture instead of having to wait for it to finish. There's also a new exposure compensation control, which will let you lock the exposure while separately locking the focus for a specific shot, which you couldn't do before. For hidden feature number 21, FaceTime calls can now stream at up to 1080p resolution, which used to be limited to only 720p, which could actually hint at future Apple Macs finally coming with 1080p webcams, but who knows. A huge new FaceTime feature coming to iOS 14 is picture-in-picture mode for FaceTime, so you can finally do something else on your iPhone and still see the person you're chatting with. And on top of that, we're finally gonna see the full implementation of the FaceTime eye contact correction feature, which makes it look like you're looking directly into the camera when you're really looking down at the display. Another feature is an update to ARKit, which allows the TrueDepth camera on the iPhone to track multiple faces for things like Snapchat filters and Memojis. For hidden feature number 25, the iPad now gets a new scratch to delete feature, allowing you to scratch out a word or a space, which in turn deletes it, instead of having to use the eraser tool or hit undo a bunch of times. One feature that a lot of people have been asking for, especially for the iPad, is support for APFS format storage drives, which didn't previously work. And for those who love using the music app, the iPad is now getting a new full screen lyrics feature, which is great for things like karaoke with your friends. Feature number 28 is more accurate weather tracking, with a new minute-by-minute precipitation chart and other new features like severe weather notifications. And for Bluetooth devices, you'll now finally get a little notification letting you know when a device has connected, compared to previously not seeing anything at all on your screen when a device connects. Another cool feature is the new history stack, which you can access by tapping and holding the back arrow button, which is useful for things like very deep settings in the Settings app, so you don't have to press the back button a bunch of times. For hidden feature number 31, you can now finally set your preferred default mail and browser apps, so when a friend sends you a web link, you can have it open using Chrome instead of Safari. And now, when an app is accessing your camera or your microphone, a little dot will pop up in the top right corner of your display, letting you know that it's either using the mic or the camera so you don't accidentally leave it on. Another feature that you might care about is text filtering within the Messages app, which can help you avoid unwanted messages and things like that. The Find My app is soon going to be able to track third-party accessories and products instead of being limited to Apple products, so this will be more convenient than using various third-party apps for tracking all of your devices. And finally, hidden feature number 35 is the ability to go into your iCloud keychain settings and see security recommendations for when your private info could have been compromised or if you have a very weak password, which should be changed. So hopefully there was at least one new iOS 14 feature that you haven't heard of yet, and if this video was helpful to you, go ahead and click the subscribe button above for more videos like this coming soon. And be sure to check out our new Apple product t-shirt design in our merch shelf below this video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.